Here we go, boys and girls. We're going to turn them loose for the last time in 2016. We're going to really miss it this year, but if you've never had a chance to do it, ought to find somewhere and give it a try. If you don't like excitement, this is not the sport for you. Kids will never remember their best day of television. I am surely going to miss the sound of those swamp howitzers. We also want to give a big old shout out to Kix Chokes and Trulow Optics, as well as my buddies over at Ballistic Products. I'm your host, Wade Bodyguard Rush, along with our co-host, Captain Buster Rush, and Josh Country Boy Branham. We made a ton of new friends this year, friends that truly made us feel like family. This is Bubba Roundtree Outdoors, South Carolina Deer Dog Drives 2016. That's going to be a wrap, but we will be back for more in 2017. Hope y'all enjoy the video.
Y'all look like one of the Chippendales.
Chipping dogs.
hey, look right behind you coming up on top. Just remember.
You gotta get used to it, boys.
Used to the element. And he was right.
He rode with the windows down. He had his windows down, too.
Yeah, roll all the windows down.
Was the heat on or off?
No.
So fast.
He was on when you got there.
When we got out on the stand, you would actually get warm. I mean,
slow, but he wasn't a
we was already frozen to death, I mean.
I said, Russell, well,
You go real quick.
Well, you know, in 1976, I went to the Olympics up in Montreal, Canada. We parked in a big parking lot. And I got out and I looked at the South Carolina vehicle there. And I went over there, and Spit Can was up there on the dash. I said, I know who that is. That's Coach Hudge.
Coach Hudge, really?
In Montreal, Canada. 1976.
We'll try to get some pretty in here. A squat. I want to get some pretty in here.
All right, Captain Buster of Bubba Roundtree Outdoors. This is going to probably be the last two dog hunts of the year. They might try to make three today. But anyway, we're over here at New Hope. We got plenty of people, so all the stands should be stood. So so they shouldn't be able to get out without getting shot at. So, anyway, I'll cut you on as soon as we get started. All right, they said turn them loose, and they are turning them loose.
Yeah, come on here. Woo! Keep going. Yeah, come on here. Come on here.
Woo! Come on, Booker. Here, find him.
It's on, boys, coming back towards the dirt road.
Did y'all rough them? Oh, they're easing that way. No, they're running, Greg. They're running. Therefore, we're going to be quiet a minute.
Ow. That bar hurt. Getting wet. How'd wear a fat man out? What? That's a big, old one. Not been laying it this morning.
I thought for a second Greg's dogs was coming, but I guess they decided to go on out and cross the Pay Road.
That deer's just piddling along out in front of flying all that water. That deer flies running, David?
No, that deer laid down when you came in the cutover. It came straight up to me right when you got in the cutover with me. And then it stopped. And I said, dang it, maybe I'm seeing things. And it laid down right in front of me. And then it got back up just then.
Well, Buckethead's coming in there to you about where you just shot. And the black dog with a bell is coming. Don't shoot jingle bells.
I still hear fly running. Where's she going? Do they sound like they're going out the other way?
They've been in there the whole time.
They're getting in that water and they just running around and around and around and around.
It's like they went to right there and then right there the hole, and then it's like three of them will get like woo woo woo, and then they just chill out.
Need to get about 10 head of dogs on to get them out of there. The problem is we got one in and two in and it's terrible. I mean, just, you've been in there before, that bottom end. Mm-hmm. All those down trees and all that water.
You can't go in there.
Dude, it's tough.
That's where I fell in the water and started cussing on the camera. And that's where I was at. And you can't. Yeah. I mean, not unless you got some waders and something.
Yeah, my feet got wet.
Stupid. Come here, Jill. Come here. I'm going right back to the swamp. Thank you.
Peg didn't shoot either. What is it? How about a Beck? That's sassy, right? Just
I'm looking in the wrong place, Daddy.
You didn't see it, Beck?
Did you get back across the road?
No, it's crossing all in between us and this cutter, and can't nobody see it.
I think he's talking about the deer buck.
I think he's running a spook because I was just standing here on the road, and he about run over the top of me, and I ain't seen nothing.
Benji's talking about that one.
Yeah, he's talking about the deer buck.
Well, him and Buck. Coming to you, Bone. Coming to you, Robbie.
Russell ought to be shooting in about 1 minute. You heard that shot go off just then, didn't you? Yeah, they're coming back.
Russell just killed one. All of a sudden, they've been shooting. Been quiet, but then all of a sudden, they start busting loose. They're going to kill two or three now, I think. Okay, finally got through with the first one. I got through with a coughing spell. But they're lining up for the second one now, so probably about 20 more minutes. I'll cut you on when we get started.
How about you, Ron? How about you, Russell? Come on.
Woo! Turn them loose!
Turn them loose, turn
them
loose.
Come out here.
Which way you need me to go, fat boy?
Just kind of. Look between us.
I'll go straight, boss. Hey, Dave Stokes, I'm right here. Freaking Stoker.
Well, JP Jr. just killed a small rack buck. Good start for the second hunt.
Ah!
up to the jungle. We in the jungle, baby. Which way are they going? Yeah, y'all got this dude tight. Got the money.
Driving, Joker.
If David Stokes would have kept on going, he would have jumped him there.
The only bar bed is this whole damn place, and that's what I got out of him. Anybody hit him? They shot at him.
This dog's running in the middle of the drive, too.
And 10 minutes later, the dogs looped around and brought two spike bucks straight to Ron. Ron gets the dogs on the buck that that he shot at last. The second buck went straight down to Russell, and Russell rolled him, but Russell's battery in the GoPro had gone dead. Here comes Josh Air walking out. He was the one driving the dogs. He's going to help Ron recover this deer.
Was it wounded? Oh yeah, that was the second one. I got the first one. I was shooting at that one too. I'm out of breath.
The bucks come out at 75 yards. Ron makes a great shot. Second shot, he folds the first one right there. The second one, we think he may have got a few bullets in him, because when Russell shot the buck, he said the buck acted like he may have been hit in the backside.
That's the one Junior kill.
That monster 6.
Yes, sirree. Wait.
It's a duck I killed.
Okay. Well, that the duck ain't quite as big. That's a nice buck. It'll go 120 pounds.
1, 2, 3,
4, 5, 6. I got to make this thing look as good as I can. All these here boys, they don't help. Pretty girl.
Thank
That's
you.
A lot.
Say what?
You are just
that
like,
who said that was a lot?
Me.
Yeah.
I'm speaking the truth.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Evidently y'all brother and sister.
Unfortunately.
What's the name of the place
for Patrick
in Florida?
No.
I'm in North Carolina.
St. Augustine?
Be happy.
I'm happy. At least I saw some.
Yeah, out front of us.
What did you do?
I didn't shoot. What'd you do?
Nothing. Other than the coffin fit.
I want to hear what happened.
I killed three dog hunting this year.
I hear you, brother. What happened with that?
Couldn't think no more. He had to go.
He run up to him and stopped and looked at him.
Black Graves going, shoot him, shoot
him. Saying, look up, Junior, look up.
Yeah, yeah, I
Zach
heard.
Going, look up, look up.
What was you doing? If
I'm
was
taking a nap. I'm on.
Now, how about tell the real story?
Zach said, look up, look up. When I looked up, he had
touched on the. Yeah, I heard all that. Heard it on the radio.
When I watched when Greg jumped and I was looking at my sister come across. I thought Zach was going to shoot him, but he's about 150 yards away.
Yeah. He probably felt sorry for you anyway.
It's a big deer.
But we will get them to sign the glasses, bro.
I only need them to see. That's the only reason I wear them, so I can see where I'm at.
Right there? Well, shoot, that ain't but about 30 yards.
Well, folks, it has been an awesome season. We hate to see it end, but we've always got next year. There's been a lot of changes. It looks like South Carolina is going to the deer tagging system starting next year as on a trial basis. We'll talk more about that in another video. Thanks for joining us, guys. Bye-bye.